next fire and fairy type until like Salad City, which will be an Eevee. Eevee can be a Flareon and a Sylveon, so therefore we get two Eevees. Well, we do get a fairy type after Camphier Town, but I don't see us getting to that point. I don't see us getting to that part where we can get that Spritzy. Yeah, it's a Spritzy. I need to trade that over to evolve it. I don't know exactly when I want to evolve it, but I don't see us getting a Spritzy in this episode. We're gonna probably get to Camphier Town and then end off. And then the episode after that, we're gonna deal with the palace and stuff. Hey, Tyranno. But we probably won't get a Spritzy until like two episodes. I think it'd be two episodes until we get to that part. This episode and then the next episode. We probably won't finish all the palace stuff in that episode. And then the episode after that, we finish up the palace and then get a Spritzy. I think these two trainers have a Plusle and Minun, which I don't think have any electric attacks. Yeah, I think they just have Helping Hand and Swift. No item over here. Item over here? Yes. Actually, I think I'm gonna go back and get a fire star. Panzer is going to need that. Is it this way? Yeah. I just need one. I'm gonna need one for my Eevee, but we can get a Firestone before we get that Eevee. But there's a Firestone before we even get to Eevee. Therefore, I don't need it right now. And since there's only one, I'm going to need one for Panzer and Eevee. So that's why I bought one. Because we can find one near the fossil, where we go get our fossil, which I won't be using a fossil because it's not my wired typing. Yeah, these two have Plusle Minun, but they don't have electric attacks. Or if they do, they never use it. This looks a lot easier to see. Gonna power up that quick attack, I see. Still does nothing, even with the help in here. Power up that quick attack again. Oh yeah, I just remember this one more rule I forgot to mention. There's a rule saying in a mono lock or a dual type lock, each Pokemon gets 3 lives. Being limited on the typing and the Pokemon you can use, there's a rule saying each Pokemon can get 3 lives. Since none of these Pokemon fainted yet, they still have 3 lives. I just remember that rule. Each Pokemon does have 3 lives in a mono lock or a dual type lock. Because there aren't that many fire types or fairy types in this game, so I'm not going to have that many Pokemon to use. Therefore, each Pokemon can have 3 lives, and none of them fainted yet, so they still all have 3 lives. I just remember that rule. But like I said, the rules will be down in the description. If I remember to put them in the description. I know they're in the description of the first episode. I put them in the description of the first episode, but I don't know if I put them in the description for the other episodes. But they should be, unless, if I remember. If I forgot, then they're probably not. But it's definitely in the first episode's description. So if you want to see the rules, just check out the first episode. Or check out just the description. I will make sure to remember to put it down in the description. But yeah, each Pokemon gets 3 lives. I do have in mind what the next series would be once. The two series we're doing right now is this one and the Ultra Sun Wonderlock. And I do have in mind, after we finish the Ultra Sun Wonderlock, I'm going to do another series of Ultra Sun. And after I finish this, I do have in mind what's next. But the other series is gonna be like Super Mystery Dungeon. Instead of doing like a Nuzlocke challenge for this next series after we finish these two, one of them is gonna be just playing Pokemon Super Mystery Dungeon, and then the other one would be another series of Ultra Sun, but it's not gonna be a Wonderlocke. I haven't decided what it's going to be. I made a straw poll asking you guys which would you like to see. But I do have in mind what the next two series will be once we get to that point. But enough talking about the next series. Let's just focus on the two we have right now. Oh, and there should be a stream tonight. Well, not tonight. There should be a stream today. I don't stream at nighttime. Well, I do every now and then, but I'm not planning to stream at tonight. It's going to be at 4 or 3 o'clock. It's either 4 or 3 o'clock. Thank goodness it didn't pursue. I know this thing can have pursuit. Well, pursuit is resistant, but still. It does more damage when you switch out. Like in my son. What was it? It was my Pokemon Sun Nuzlocke. Pursuit was resistant on the Alolan Grimer, and it got killed by Pursuit because I tried to switch it out. Because it was low on health, and I was trying to train it. Even if it was resistant, Pursuit does more damage when you switch out, so it would have killed. Maybe. I don't know. But thank goodness it didn't go for Pursuit, because I know that thing has Pursuit. Well, could get Pursuit. But a lot of people voted for Fire and Fairy, so that's why I ended up with these two types. I was thinking grass at first, but a lot of people wanted fire, so I went ahead and went with fire. How much does this do? How much does this do? I could have just healed you and kept fighting, but I didn't feel like it. I'm just gonna let Ashley handle this. I think you're almost a fire type. Yep, I'm pretty sure Fretchling's almost close to being a fire type. That's a guy with a cadaver. I would have to say Brazikin God is the best bet for this guy. And I don't know what that item is. I would go back and I would go get it after I fight him. Fight me. Yep, I knew it. I knew it. I knew this was coming. But I think this is the right choice. Okay, it's being stupid. It was being stupid. If it went to like side beam or something, it could have done a lot of damage and probably almost kill us. But it was being stupid, so it didn't. kill us. But even if it did kill us, Blaziken King God would still have two lives left. For Bebe, almost lost a life, but I switched out, so. I remember that rule because I was watching someone else earlier who's doing a mono lock. And I watched someone else who was doing a dual type lock. And two of their Pokemon only have one life yet left. Oh, why are you still? I meant to switch you for someone else. How long has this been? 17 minutes. Let's use Ashley. Game Lock and Savage Luck need to catch up. Game Lock needs to evolve. And catch up in levels. That's why I haven't used it. It's not evolved. And it can't really do anything right now. But Bebe can do something. It just can't take hits. But Game Block barely does any damage. Her Bebe at least does some damage. And it's actually really decent damage. But Game Block can't do any type of damage. And it can't take hits. But for Bebe can take a few hits. Game Lock takes one hit, and then next hit would most likely kill. For Bebe, can take 2 to 3 hits and not die. But they'd be better once they catch up in levels and once they evolve. Well, we got an evolution. Game Lock's level 14. Still doesn't like me. I've been running around and running around. Still doesn't like me. Like I said, this can have pursuit. I need to go back and get potions. Peck did more than everything else. Well, then again, Peck is stronger than Quick Attack, I think. Which is weird. Quake Attack and Peck are both stab. Actually, no. I think Peck is weaker than Quake Attack. And they're both stab. So they should have done at least the same. But Peck did more and it wasn't a crit. But yeah, I need to go back and get potions. I see you guys once I am back and done buying potions. I see you guys in a few. Okay, I bought potions and everything. What do you have? I don't remember what you have. I just remember the guy with the cadaver. I remember the Skidoo. Also, the Skidder. Bidoof. We can take on a Bidoof, can't we, Savage? Or maybe we can't. I don't know why I kept you in. I know we have the experience shares on, so I don't really need to keep you in. And experience is not split anymore, so. Everyone gets the same amount of experience. Except if you're the one in the battle, you get more. But other than that, everyone gets the same amount. Get a little bit more if you're actually in the battle, but yeah. Evolution number 2. Great way to end off the episode, because I'm actually about to end it. We didn't get all the way as far as I hoped, but we made some progress. I was hoping to at least get to Camphor Town, but we didn't get to it, but it's okay. We get to Camphor Town the next episode. 50, 40, priority. I keep Quick Attack. Just in case I'm in a situation, I need to make sure we outspeed. But yeah, good way to end the episode. But if you enjoyed this episode, leave a like on the channel and want to get notifications of when I upload. Feel free to subscribe. And of course, don't forget to answer the comment question of the day down below and in the comments. And also, if you ever want to chat, feel free to join my Discord. The link to my Discord will be down below in the description with the rules of a dual type lock. But I'll see you guys next time for the next episode of Pokemon Y dual type lock. Goodbye.